What's up, guys? Welcome back once again to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. Look at what we have here. The silver play button arrived from YouTube for crossing 100,000 subscribers on the Gaming Careers channel. I unboxed this yesterday on stream, so thanks very much to everybody that came and watched. You see? Award time. They got it right! Oh. But today's video, I'm going to be talking to all of those streamers that have a single monitor setup. And you know, you still want to be interacting with chat, you still want to be having that conversation with people, but you don't want to be alt-tabbing the whole time, you don't want to be reading it on your phone when it's super small, and you don't want to have your game running in a tiny resolution so that you can line up your chat next to it. Well, today I have a solution for all of you, and it is a way of being able to have your chat with transparency overlaid over your game, so that you can keep interacting with chat, and it works with Twitch, YouTube, Mixer, and Facebook. All of that coming up after a message from today's video sponsor. BlueStacks 4 is an application that allows you to play Android games on your PC. Now, you obviously get a significant performance improvement over a traditional mobile device, but there's a huge benefit here of it being much easier to capture and stream these games from OBS or Streamlabs OBS to a platform like Twitch, YouTube, or Mixer. If you're interested in streaming mobile games, creating content for mobile games, or you just want to play mobile games on your PC, then check out the link in the description. So to get started with this cool application that allows you to read and interact with your Twitch chat whilst still playing in your game, we need to head to restream.io/chat. And I know what you're thinking, Pete, you've already done a video on Restream, you know, that website where you can stream to 30 different platforms simultaneously. And yes, you're right, I have. If you haven't seen that video, you can check it out in the card up top. But Restream have also built a chat application that allows you to do this cool thing with transparency and having the window always remaining on top of your game. So head over to restream.io/chat, and we need to be looking for this link up here where it says looking for the desktop version of the program, and you click desktop chat and it should bring you to a page where you can then download the software for Windows. So exactly as you always do with your downloads and installation, go through the normal setup process and I will see you as we launch the application. Next, what we're going to need to do is log into our Restream account. So if you don't already have one, it's a super simple free sign up and it allows you to connect a few of your different streaming accounts, so Twitch or YouTube or Mixer or multiple of these if you want to, into Restream so that you can then use this application to chat on those platforms. So if you've got an account, log in. If you don't, sign up, it's very, very easy. Once you've successfully logged into the Restream platform, you should get this chat box here, and this is a chat window exactly the same as the one that you have on Twitch or on Mixer or on YouTube. You can see up here I have only connected my Twitch account, so down here I can select to respond to numerous chats if I have numerous platforms that I'm streaming to, but for me I'm just going to stream to my Twitch, so I can respond directly to my Twitch chat through this chat box. However, the thing is with this chat box is that it can be hidden by other windows, so I can quite easily alt-tab to a different program and it still gets hidden behind it. And we want it to appear in front of everything as well as in front of our game. So for that, we're gonna need to head into the settings. So you come up here and click the little settings cog. Now it'll take us to the accounts tab, but the one that we really care about is called appearance. So if we click across to the appearance tab, we can see some options. And the first option, hopefully super self-explanatory, window always on top. So if I click this, this will mean that the chat window is now always on top. And what I mean by that is I can go to my Google Chrome tab and I could go to, you know, the Gaming Careers website or keep using Google Chrome or any other application, and my chat window is still staying on top of that. Now that's all good and useful, but it is completely blocking part of our screen. So you can imagine if we had a game running and we had our chat up in the top corner like this, we would be not able to see the top corner of our game. So we want to add some transparency to this. So if we jump back into the settings, you can see the next option is to enable transparency. If we check that, we then get some options down here as we can change the opacity of our window. Now this is largely going to be personal preference of how much opacity you want, and probably depends on what game you're playing and how light or how dark it is. But just for now, before we start playing around with settings, I'll give you what I typically use, and that is to set the window opacity all the way down to the minimum, which is 1%, and then the message opacity, which is actually the messages that show on top of our chat, I set that to around 30%. Now that is instantly going to make it very hard to see where our chat window is. If you see me moving this blue bar, you can see part of the chat window still, So I'm just going to set the window to maybe 20% or something, just whilst we continue setting up the software, and then I'm going to drag that back down to 1% when we are ready to actually use it. So what other options do we still have here? Use GPU, I don't recommend using that, neither does Restream by the looks of it. Show in taskbar just means that the application is going to show in the taskbar. Show view account, that just shows a view account of how many people are watching your stream at the top of the chat window, which is a useful little tidbit of information that you can have still whilst you're playing your game. Now, click through mode, this is a useful option. This basically means that you can still interact with the chat window if you hold down the hotkey. The hotkey by default is set to control. If in your game you're going to be using control, then it's worth setting this to something else. But if I enable this option, I can show you exactly how to use it. So if I hold down control, I can now click this got it button and I can drag this window around and I can, you know, type back into my chat or whatever. But if I let go of control, I can't interact with it anymore. I can't interact with that chat window. So if I hold down control, I can move it. Let's move up to the top corner, which is probably where we're going to have it. But if I let go of control and try and move it, I'm actually moving my window, the browser behind it. So useful option to be able to interact directly with the chat window. The last couple of options, URL display. This just means that it's going to replace any URLs in your chat with tiny URL, which is useful because you don't want loads and loads of text filling up your screen. So enable that if you wish to. And finally, you have some options for font sizes of the message, the person that's chatting, their nickname, as well as if you want a timestamp or not. I'm going to leave those at their default, and I'm going to turn this right back down to 1%, which is going to look like it's completely disappeared, but it is still there. And once I get some chat in there, you're going to see exactly how that's going to look for our game. So if we now close down these settings and we head across to our Twitch chat and just type in an example message, let's say, hello world. You can now see that it comes up, and it's difficult to see because it's overlaid over so many different colors, but that has come up in our Twitch overlay. If I open a new tab, it's probably going to be a little bit easier to see. So there you can see the 1% opacity of my actual Twitch window, of the chat window, and the 30% opacity of each message. Now this might need to be turned up a little bit, but it is quite difficult to see on such a light background. Once we go to a darker background, such as in a game, hopefully it's going to be easier to see. So let's start up a game now. So here I am in Overwatch, or, you know, any example game, and you can see that right now my Twitch chat isn't showing in the top corner, and that is because I have the game running in full screen mode. And to be able to use this program, you need to be running your game in windowed or borderless window. So it can still take up the full screen, but it needs to be running in one of those options. Otherwise, you need to have some complex coding to do with DirectX, and it gets very difficult. So if we come up to find your options in the game that you're playing, the video options, and you'll usually have this display mode near the top. I'm going to go to borderless window, so I'm still going to be running full screen, but it's going to be running in a window. So if I press enter to restart the game, you can now see that I have my chat appearing in the top, and I can interact with this chat. It's quite difficult because it's overlaid with the settings up in the top. But if I press control, I can now type back, hello back to you. And you can see it comes up in the chat there. So maybe 30% was a little bit too low. I probably would go back and tweak that so that the messages are appearing a little bit darker, maybe 50% or something like that. So let's go back to our Restream chat settings and up that to 50%. So I just actually did quit the game, and then I realized that you can actually do this whilst the game is still running. Because of course, if you hold down control, whatever hotkey we had set, you can click the options settings still. So if you hold down whatever your hotkey was, click the settings cog, you can bring up the options and you can change the transparency from here. So let's just up the message transparency from 30% to 50% and see how that looks. And that is a lot more legible. And of course, you can play around. If you would like to show the window a bit as well with some transparency, you can change that here as well. I prefer that actually to be completely off and then just have the messages showing up as an overlay. And as you can see there, you have Twitch chat whilst playing a game in full screen. Yes, you're playing borderless or borderless window, but you're still playing using your full screen on a single monitor. You can reply directly if you just use your hotkey, type into the chat box what you want to type back, but you can read all your comments as they come in live from Twitch. Hopefully you have found that video helpful. You now should have your Twitch chat or your YouTube chat, Mixer chat, whatever streaming platform you have, overlaid on top of your game, where you can drag it where you want, you can size things how you want, you can change the opacity so that it really works for the game and how you want to interact with your chat. Make sure that you can read it, obviously, but also make sure it's not too distracting so that you can still perform the best that you can whilst playing the game. Hopefully that video has been helpful. If it has, please do give us a thumbs up on the YouTube video. That really does help us out. And obviously, if you haven't yet subscribed to the YouTube channel, please look around at the massive amount of tutorials that we have been producing for live streaming and for content creation within the gaming niche. As always, a huge thank you to my patrons this month who have helped support the Gaming Careers YouTube channel and help support the creation of videos like this for the greater Gaming Careers community. Again, thank you to everybody that subscribed over the last year and a half. Absolute unbelievable achievement to hit 100,000 subscribers in less than 2 years. And I thank every single one of you for helping make this my dream job. Hopefully I'm helping you guys along the way as well. And subscribers, I will see you in the next video. Peace.